lower back pain treatment. This is an excerpt from a full presentation on lower back pain generally. You can click on this very link to take you to the full presentation on lower back pain. For now, here is the excerpt, and that will be on lower back pain treatment only. Now, the treatment. Well, don't let me say I know, but let me say my assumption is that many people will click on this very presentation because they just want to know how to treat lower back pain that they are having, or their friends are having, or their parents are having, as the case may be. So, now we've reached where many people will want us to go. The treatment of lower back pain. Is it all the time we need pills? I don't think so. It's not all the time that I will prescribe pills for someone having lower back pain. Remember everything we've gone through before we reach this stage. Now, we must first of all determine if we are dealing with red flags or not. So we might even need referral right now. We may not even do anything right now because it is more serious than what could be done at the clinic. Or it's more serious than what could be done by determined by the level of my training or not. Okay? So sometimes we'll refer immediately. And let me end that by saying, for example, the diagnosis is dissecting, abdominal, aortic aneurysm. What am I waiting for? Cardiothoracic unit. Immediate classification into benign or severe is pretty important. So we cannot just be toying with human lives, nor making a guess. No, we must make that determination quickly, that this is benign, okay? We will do nothing, or we'll do just a little stuff, or this is severe. Another person must take over right now. That determination must be made immediately. Majority will not require much. In fact, some will require no treatment, zero. Zero. So, majority will not require much intervention, or at least they will require just minimal intervention, and then they will have the lower back pain resolved in 2 to 6 weeks. Okay, if we have made up our mind that, okay, this is what we can handle, this will need no referral, this will need no other department to handle it, let's start with non-pharmacological intervention. First thing first, education. The patient should be advised against making the injury to become worse. Okay? So, another issue will be cooperation between the doctor or the therapist and the affected person. That will be vital. If there is depression or anxiety, that should be addressed. We should ask history surrounding depression and anxiety. If not, there's no pill you give. The patient is coming back. We should let whoever is having lower back pain know that doctor shopping, looking for opiate, is not the way out. As a matter of fact, we should state the consequences of opioid abuse. That may, but not limited to, death. Non-pharmacological intervention can also include the following if it is benign. Benign and not interrupting normal daily activities of the affected person. If that is the case, we can just tell the individual, continue your normal daily activities. Yeah, just continue. Be doing what you are doing, continue to enjoy your life. No more exercise, right? And advise that Don't ask for sick leave. No. Don't stop working. Continue to go to work. But we'll make that determination when we know this is extremely benign, not interrupting sleep, not interrupting daily activities. So if that is the case, just continue. Don't go home and rest. Don't go and sleep on bed for 2 days, no. But if it's a bit more than the above here, then we can ask for 2 days of bed rest. We'll then issue sick leave. Please let this staff of yours rest for 2 days. That's my determination, if it is greater than the number one here, okay? Assurance of early recovery. But the affected person may seek for longer bed rest. I will let you know. That would be detrimental. Still on non-pharmacological intervention, please continue active exercise. Remember, sedentary lifestyle is a risk factor. Then you can apply ice. If you are used to heat, heat application will help. So you choose either ice application or heat application. Laser or massage. But some might not be able to afford this one. So if you have coverage for them, good. Wear good shoes. In fact, part of the physical examination should have involved checking the shoes, right? The soles of the shoes also. Look for the way to share the weight. Have a good diet. Stop smoking. I've explained how smoking could lead to lower back pain. Let me say it for the last time. When you are smoking, and you have been smoking for a long time, and you are coughing repeatedly, that is not caused by cancer, not caused by tuberculosis or anything else, that frequent coughing can lead to a herniated disc. And the smoking also can lead to ischemia that will eventually lead to osteoporosis. If there are associated disease or diseases and such has been identified, that must be treated also, like depression, anxiety, diabetes mellitus, whether it's trauma with fracture, let the fracture be fixed quickly. Nephrolithiasis now should be treated appropriately. Dissecting aortic aneurysm. Do I even need to leave this here? That will be referred immediately and be handled immediately. Pancreatitis to the appropriate unit and pancreatic carcinoma to oncologists. Now, pharmacological intervention. We will start with the lower here, okay? Topical analgesics, Voltaren, and so on. Acetaminophen, Tylenol, paracetamol, whatever you call it in your region. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Yeah, I will not rush through this. Here it could be ibuprofen, could be naproxen, but those ones will cause gastrointestinal tract ulceration. Okay? In that case, you have misoprostol, Cytotec, is the better option when it comes to non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs related peptic ulcer. Misoprostol is better. But if proton pump inhibitors will be what is available in your region, like omeprazole, you can add. So either Cytotec, misoprostol, or omeprazole proton pump inhibitors, in addition to your ibuprofen or naproxen, that will help the patient. But if you want to, you know, avoid gastrointestinal tract, you can use electrosbit. That is good because it will not give you gastrointestinal tract ulceration much, but you'll be dealing with another complication, like myocardial ischemia. Okay, then you can go leave this stage to muscle relaxant. Narcotics, could see I put a lot of stars here. We have to be careful because of the possibility of addiction, right? So we're not going to go for the highest level like morphine, hydromorphone, no. Oxycodone and hydrocodone will be fine. Then, if we are not winning, we can have antidepressant on top of that, like tricyclic antidepressant, amitriptyline can be helpful, and then duloxetine, that is important, can be helpful. But remember the anticholinergic side effects of tricyclic antidepressant. That must be fully explained. Some went back on steroid injection. Then physiotherapy or physical therapy is the same. Just one is zero, one is North America. So, and then you refer to spine surgical unit for intervention by spine surgeon. In that order. Surgery may involve cortisone injections, radiofrequency neurotomy, or implanted nerve stimulators. Specific treatment could be embarked upon under specific diagnosis. For example, acute radiculopathy. If that is the case, we can have the individual advise that you have to decrease certain activities with the goal of decreasing exacerbation. Okay? Then, instead of no bed rest, continue activities, continue to go to work, no. We will actually give sick leave of 3 days. Rest at home for 3 days. Bed rest for 3 days, not 2 days. Then, use non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. Celecoxib, naproxen, ibuprofen, then protect the gastrointestinal tract with proton pump inhibitors or misoprostol. Then, if you're not winning, you can add narcotics, but we're not going for hydromorphone now. We'll just settle at the level of oxycodone and so on. Then, lumbar traction, and then transcutaneous electrical nerve stimulation. In case of osteoporotic compression fractures or even any other causes of lower back pain, you can embark on the use of causes. So, like lumbar to sacral orthosis, some will put it as lumbosacral orthosis. You can embark on that, on braces, bar supports, and abdominal binders. Now, you've done everything so far, and you need surgery. Well, let's see where and when surgery will be required. If it is cardiac equina syndrome, that is an acute emergency. Surgical decompression. Laminectomy will be required right now. In the case of dissecting, abdominal, aortic, aneurysm, cardiothoracic unit immediately. If this anation or spinal stenosis, we revert to spine surgeon.